GLGL. Alright, we got called. By ace queen, we need a 10 guys, otherwise we bust in 13th. Can we fade it? It would be very important. Just give me a low card, please. Is that low enough? That is low enough. Come on! Come on! That's the time to hit the 3-outer. First two times we empty bubble today. Or we busted the final two tables. Let's change it here with the run good. Come on. Kings. 12 left. Come on. Come on, this is huge. A7. Fade that ace. Please. Please fade it. There's no ace on the river. So many other beautiful cards like the Jack of Hearts. Come on. Let's go. And back then, like as a micro player, I studied with training videos, but there wasn't, and ICMizer, but there wasn't like great tools like DTO yet. All right, we are losing our first player. Yep, we are down to 8. Holy shit. That's insane if we lose the big stack here. I mean, this guy ripped an ace 10 for 30, I think. Yeah. Look at that. This guy busts in 8th place, which is insane. Since he had more chips than I did, so everybody's super excited. Myself included. We don't mind him being gone. That's just going to be an open jam. Hoping that Riverhams doesn't wake up with the hand, but it's so tough for him. Like, if he has ace-queen here, he should fold, I think. So, that's why these type of jams become really, really good. Jam would be terrible if he's in the big blind, for example. So, when he's in the big blind, we just fold everything. Blinds increase, as you see, everybody just drops super short now. I mean, I drop from, like, almost 30 down to 20. I mean, this guy covers me now, so check and suit is a bit of a decision, but not too much, because he still shouldn't call me wide at all, because then he's the short stack if he loses, so... I'm like very, very certain this is still a jam. I mean, 100% certain. Nah, very, very certain. Like 95%. Hopefully, it just goes through. Very, very nice again. It's so important, these spots, man, just to stay afloat, you know? Oh man, he makes the call. Ace queen. Ooh, that's come on, fade that check, please. Huge pot here. Fade that check on the river. Don't do it. Just don't be a jack. Spade, be spade. It is spade. Come on, we knock him out. Let's go. Oh, that was crucial. Alright, guaranteed $1,000. Second and chips, let's keep it going. Limping in with the king jack into this guy's big blind again. I'm gonna check it back on the flop. Usually we want to bet a lot on this texture, but now we're just switching our strategies to what's being just way tighter. Anything that gets fewer chips into the middle is better. He then bets the turn. We have an easy call. I can see him betting a king 10. The variety of flush draws. On the brick river, I won't be folding. I hope he doesn't go too big. I mean, if he pots it here, then I actually hate my life. If he goes like half pot, then we just snap call and see king 7 of hearts. Feels like he has two pair, but I don't know if I'm ever folding here. The thing is, he can still have king 9 and just not like be aware that I would check these type of hands on the flop. So folding here could be a massive plunder. Alright, there's the bluff. Very, very nice stuff, guys. Man, this final table is really nice so far. Yeah, important flop check there. I mean, this guy is obviously way too wide. And let's see if he's aware of his situation. He calls. I think I have to attempt a little bet here. Come on, just fold your pocket nines, mate. Boom. That is very important. Such a nice pot to win. Because now I have a little bit of breathing room. This guy's down to 18 big blinds. A6 suited, very easy open jam here. And now I can just open jam. And I can survive a hit if one of these guys wakes up with it, which is very nice. Makes the entire spot more comfortable. When you jam 30 big, or like with 30 big blind stacks and you only have 35 yourself, then things can change rapidly, but this way it's a little bit better. Theoretically speaking, I would assume the queen six suited is actually an open jam, but I'm just going to go with the raise because I think it's going to be very similar and these guys wouldn't play back that much and I risk less this way. So opened up, this guy decides to go for it for his last chips with 9-8 suited, which I think is a mistake given how short this guy is. I think he should be just trying to wait him out, see if he can hit a queen jack 6 or if the cockroach is staying alive. Spade is good, 3 of spades not good enough. So he doubles, but once again, doesn't matter too much. And this guy runs into it, ace king versus pocket 9s. Wouldn't mind ace king winning this one. But maybe it's time to get a ladder here. Spade is good, 5 of spades not good enough for him. He's out. Let's keep it going. Alright, so now we have the guy to my right that has a bunch of chips, but luckily he's to my right, so I can still jam quite wide here. Myself, like the king 3 off is an easy jam. This guy doesn't really want to call right now at all with him being so short. Yeah, and I get this nice cutoff spot as well. King 5 off has to go in. I hope this guy does understand the situation, doesn't like go for a punt call here, which can always happen. But we get another fold. Just leave it on the final table, the action is too insane up here. We can fold a little bit like this one. Ace 10 offsuit, we go for it. The guy has 1.6 big blinds there. He calls any 2 obviously. Let's hope I hold, I guess. I don't care about the result here. If he's alive, then we can apply more pressure. If he busts, then I win a few chips and I can still apply heaps of pressure. Spade means I win. We are down to 4, guaranteed 13,000, which is about $2,000. Let's keep it rolling. Yep, in we go. Just gonna open jam this and hope Big Ben doesn't make some absurd punt call here. I think he's technically supposed to fold ace king here, so we pretty much never get called here by him. Yeah. It's really important to open jam here, because if I raise and this guy rips an ace queen, it's a disaster for me, because, well, he got to win chips with ace queen, which is just always a fold there. Comes in with the min raise blind versus blind. I could technically raise my hand, but he bets big. I'm just gonna pile and hope he calls ace king and I hold. Huge spot here. Wait. I mean, how often is he gonna bluff here? Pretty much never. He goes large on the flop already. Yeah, we're going for it. Hopefully holding against ace king. We just bluffed. I don't mind the fold there, honestly. We can just grind them out down now. Mix up with checks. Sure, take it. I don't mind losing a few blinds. I would take a 7 on the river though. Spade is good. 3 not so much. Hope this guy doesn't have aces. But yeah, man. Really hope we don't run to aces here. Yeah, that's pretty annoying. I think it's gonna open more hands than just aces there, so that rejam should be fine. Come on, 9-7, please. 7. No. Yeah, bad timing. But I think it's fine. It depends. If he only has an open jamming range there, and then just raises aces and kings, then obviously it's not good, but I can see other hands being raised too. So now positions change again. I'm just gonna be stuck not folding until the other two guys bust. Too bad. I could have just called preflop, honestly. Definitely interesting. We lose a flip, ace versus ace check here. 7 big blinds, I think we call deuces. Alright, let's win the flip. Oh! Maybe it's just a punt to jam there. But then again, like, these guys are just opening to wide in these type of spots as well, you know, and that's the thing that makes the jam nice. But then again, are they? Tough to say. He donks out. We call. Check's turn. Check back. Checks river. OP is queen check, half pot, he will call. There it is. Nice. Alright, we're almost in the chip lead again. Ah, the pocket 9 spot haunts me though. It's nice that I made the comeback afterwards, but it's so easy to be a mistake. Like, we have so many nice spots to pick there, and that pocket 9's rejam spot is just not nice at all. He opens into 2-8 big blind stacks. It's just, like, obviously it's a setup, and we should always jam under Chippy V, but under ICM, I think that's actually better as a either fold or call, because there's so many easy spots, you know, and we just increase our variance massively for a jam that isn't even worth that much, given how many other better spots we have there. So I can see that 9 just being a big mistake by myself, and I certainly regret it now. He just, yeah, it's just a mistake there. It was a dumb mistake I made, but looks like I don't get punished for it. Hopefully I can win the heads up now. Guaranteed 24,000, which is a bit over 3k. Let's play a little heads up by 12 tabling and win the tournament. Good luck, guys. Oh, okay. All right. Ooh, great turn. Flush on the river sucks. We have a shit flush as well. I think this flush becomes a check call. Snap pot, bet, eh? It's a bit weird. Because, like, why does he go this big on the flop with, like, an ace-x? This is a7 with the ace of diamonds. Like, he struggles having the check of diamonds, the 10 of diamonds, when he doesn't bet the turn. I don't think people bluff here too often though, but obviously if he has like 9-8 of clubs, I can see it. Tough to say. Hero call, show me 9-7. 10-8, there we go. Boom! Very, very nice. Yeah, I think my logic given his flop sizing is pretty sound there. Dave with the resub, welcome back home, thank you very much. Hopefully he finds a 3-bet jam here. 4-bet jam, pardon me. Makes a call, king on the flop, SPR is shallow though. Do start with a c-bet here, gonna put in 4 BB. Oh my god, do I hate this spot. Oh my fucking god. It's obviously never a thing to raise this flop in a 3-bet pot. Oh, is that nasty. Some people do it with 7s, but then they jam 7s pre-flop as well. It's a disaster if he does this with ace 5 and I fold. But we're obviously pretty dead against the king here. Like, this is absolutely never ever a thing. He could have 3-4, but it's also, like, less likely. I think I just have to muck it, and sometimes he's gonna have 7s here and just get super lucky that I fold this. But I think we don't really want to get it in there and just grind him down a bit in better spots. Oh, that's so annoying. Huge pot we lose there. All the raise, he bets, he's 60%, I call. Great turn, I could donk here. I just hope he revert the queen, and that means he will always call 5 BB. I might lose a little bit of value from a king here by using the sizing. But I guarantee the call from a hand like queen 5, which I think is quite important. I don't really have bluffs here given his flop size, so we need to pick a size that he will snap call with a hand like that, and he picked it that, so I'm happy with my size. King queen here, actually like a big bet. Great turn, we're just going big bet all the way, and hopefully the hand is just done after this one. I had a turn, it's just done. Alright, so we didn't flop straight. Oh shit. Queen 5, please. 9-8 of diamonds with the bluff. We take it down. Let's fucking go. Woo! Beautiful stuff. Come on. 33,001. That is big. $4,500 here. Very nice win in the Zodiac main event. Nice. It's like a $40 buy-in, 45k, 4,500 in the bank, profitable session, let's fucking go. As I said, 3 videos a week. If you want to see more content, just a cream that I cream, the best deep runs, you can just drop this up there. I would appreciate it. Otherwise, I'll see you guys tomorrow for another stream. and more final tables. See you then. Have a good night. Peace out.